Namaste YouTube, welcome to Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to Cats in the Cradle by Harry Chapin. It's a Patreon request and this is the first time single take honest reaction to it.
Yeah, so let's get started. We are reacting to the lyric video and let's get started.
Child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch and bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking for I knew it. And as he grew, he'd say, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cats in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man. Coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. My son turned 10 just the other day. He said, thanks for the ball, Dad, come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? I said, not today, I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay. He walked away, but his smile never dimmed. Said, I'm gonna be like him. Yeah, you know I'm gonna be like him. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. Well, he came from college just the other day. So much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you. Can you sit for a while? He shook his head and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, Dad. You know we'll have a good time then. I've long since retired, my son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I can find the time. You see, my new job's a hassle and the kids are the flu, but it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me he'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. Silver spoon, little boy blue and the man on the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, Dad. We're gonna have a good time then.
What goes around comes around, doesn't it?
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on this one, Kirti?
This composition is so beautiful. It tells us the life story of a man and the childhood of his son, as well as the adulthood and his life, in a very small song, in a very beautiful way, in a very musical way, with the great music, the guitaring, the tune, the voice and everything, and we still get the message. It's so beautiful.
The message was loud and clear.
Yeah, we'll every line
take
of it.
Take it up verse for verse as it comes on the screen.
Yeah,
but it basically had five distinct parts.
Yeah.
One was when the baby came into the world, the son of the man. he was away when he started to crawl, walk.
You can read.
Yeah, my child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way. But there were planes to catch and bills to play. He learned to walk while I was away.
He wasn't even there.
Yeah, he wasn't there when he learned to walk and crawl.
Then he was a toddler.
And he was talking before I knew it. And as he grew, he'd say, I'm going to be like you, Dad. You know, I'm going to be like you. Wow, how wonderful are these words. This has got to be the best song lyrically dealing with this topic.
Yes.
Topic of parents
it's
and kids.
Very, very clear and very, very clear. Precise.
It's about quality time. Parents are busy in their own world. When kids grow up, they get busy in their own world, in their friend circle, with their peers, and they start working.
It
will connect to probably most of the planet, this particular song. And that's why it is already, in my opinion, the best song lyrically. Music was good too, very, very simple, very, very catchy. And it was just so heartfelt. I mean, the baby came into the world, the father was in there, while he was walking, while he was crawling, walking, starting to talk, father was in there. The father was busy with, you know, putting food on the table, bills to pay, so he was traveling, he was working long hours. And how common is that? There was statistics done, surveys done about this particular topic in Mumbai itself. Mm-hmm. And years ago in Mumbai Mirror, one of the leading dailies, they said that people spend 12 to 14 hours, working people, spend 12 to 14 hours outside the home on working days. 12 to 14
that
hours.
That is true.
So that is practically the whole waking, the whole day that you are awake. You're away from your home. You're away from your kids. You're away from your pets. You're away from whatever else that is there in your home. You're basically out.
Your spouse, your hobbies.
Yeah, and the most shocking statistic of that is that more than 4 of those 12 to 14 hours, 15 hours are spent traveling.
On travel, yeah.
So traveling, getting ready, traveling, getting to work, coming back from work, the daily grind, that takes up most of the time. So it's a common problem all over the world. And Harry Chapin has written it so beautifully. The second verse goes like this, and then I'll allow you to share your experience, anything.
Yeah.
And the cat's in the cradle, this was a chorus. There was a mistake in the lyric video. We'll try and correct it before it goes online.
Okay.
Where the last two verses have son instead of dad.
Ah.
You know, instead
yeah,
of
yeah, yeah, yeah.
So here the chorus goes, and the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you coming home, Dad, I don't know when. But we'll get together then. We'll have a good time then. So the son, the baby, the son longs for the company of the dad. Longs for the dad to be home so that they can spend quality time together, they can have good times together, they can play together. That comes up in the verse after this at the age of 10. What are your thoughts on all this?
We say most of the parents always wonder, what do I teach my child? What do I teach my child? How do I train them? How do I bring them up so that they are ready for the world? And this is no myth now that your children learn what you do. More than what you tell them, more than what you read to them, more than what you teach them, and more than what you try to fit in their brain, they are watching you the way you do things.
Yeah, it's a...
They are constantly seeing what is happening more than what... If you may have a one-hour session with them, teaching them what they are going to learn from you, that 12 to 14 hours that they are awake and they are watching you around, that is more impactful on them.
Yeah, human beings and all animals mostly learn through imitation.
We imitate, yeah.
It is well said with the 100 monkey effect in Japan, where it was studied that the monkeys just learn things magically just because they saw one monkey doing it. You know, where they used to drop these food for the monkeys.
Yeah.
I don't remember which food, whether it was coconuts or berries or bananas, right?
Uh-huh.
They would drop these bananas, big bunches of bananas on an island in Japan,
mm-hmm.
where they were studying the behavior of monkeys decades ago. And they would see that the bananas would get dirty, but they couldn't do anything because they were just dropping them.
Mm-hmm.
They did not want to interfere in their, you know, life.
How they behaved.
How they behave, how they lived.
Mm-hmm.
So the monkeys would have to dust off these bananas, some would get squashed and things like that, they couldn't be eaten. Then finally one day one monkey, one old wise monkey, took the bananas and went and washed it in the lake nearby.
Uh-huh.
And then after that, everyone realized.
All of them did that.
All of them learned that. So that is how children also learn. One day they see the parents doing that.
Yeah.
And that is exactly, and so beautifully.
Put
requires
it,
a lot of wisdom to write a song
words
like this.
Like that, yeah.
I wonder who the lyricist of this song is. This is beautiful. They have had to have been through this, and they've had to have been a parent and a child who's faced this. I bet you. My son turned 10 just the other day. He said, "Thanks for the ball, Dad. Come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw?" I said, "Not today." Those are sad words when you hear that. I've heard it myself from my father, and I really, really connected with it when this came on. "I got a lot to do," he said, "that's okay," and he walked away, but his smile never dimmed.
I really liked
beautiful lines, that even though his father told him no,
he
walked away, his smile never dimmed. I mean, kids are kids after all, so pure, so innocent, so good. It said, "I'm going to be like him, I'm going to be like him." Your thoughts on this, Kirti?
He still believes, the small boy. Even though his dad doesn't have much time, and he likes him so much, he adores him so much. Both of them have, you know, mutual love for each other. But then this time that the father doesn't have, and the son doesn't really mind it. But he keeps adoring his father, and he keeps saying that one day I will be like him. And the dad didn't know that what exactly he was going to be like him. What exactly, which trait, which quality was going to be like him. And he realized when he grew older, this is exactly what he got.
This is exactly what he got. What goes around comes around. The best message ever. And for all those parents who are watching this reaction or have heard this song, I think the message is loud and clear. Spend more quality time with your kids, and to grown-up kids and teenagers and grown-up kids and young adults. If your fathers, if your mothers are still alive, it's not just about fathers. Even though the focal point is father and son.
Yeah.
It's about parents and kids. It's about brothers and sisters. Spend time with your loved ones. Spend time with each other. Quality time. I mean, I remember, of course, I've created a story about this. It's one of the most popular short stories I've written called Little Rekha. But I'll get to that maybe at the end if you have time.
Yeah.
Or I'll share it on Patreon with our Patreons as an audiobook or a video.
It's
I don't
more
know if
than
I have the video.
Two or more decades old. Yeah,
and there have been so many other trainers and people. In fact, an ad has been made about this story. But anyway, maybe the inspiration was this, not my story. Well, he came from college just the other day. So much like a man, I just have to say. Here is where the father wants to spend time with the son now. He realizes he missed out.
Yeah.
He realized he missed out on quality time, and he wants to spend time with his son. "Son, I'm so proud of you," he said. "Can you sit for a while?" He shook his head, the son, and he said with a smile, "What I'd rather like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys." Wow, that's the age that we all can connect with. The bike keys, the car keys. Borrow them. If you have a second home,
see
borrow
them.
See
you later. Can I have
enjoy
the keys?
Enjoy with your friends. Enjoy on your own. Don't really want to spend time with your parents. "See you later. Can I have them, please?" Wow. This is what I loved. I mean, this is what you get if you ignore your loved ones while they are growing up. This is what you get when they are grown up.
I find it ironic most times. So, you know, we often come across old people who are put in the old age homes, and their children are away and they can't take care of them because they have their own responsibilities, their own bills to pay, their own families to take care. And at that time, those who hear about them, or those who gossip or talk about those parents, they really make those children like criminals. That what kind of heart those children have, that they are leaving their parents in an old age home, or, you know, they are treating them so badly as if they are not family. But then I feel it comes from what you have done in the past, the upbringing they have got. Probably you weren't there around for them. They never made that connection with you that you gave them, and they would give it back to you.
Yeah.
It may have gone all wrong right from the beginning.
Yeah, I mean, the stats are everything. The lyrics are everything. The stats are 14 hours of a weekday, of a working day, spent outside the home, away from kids, away from everything. I mean, you basically are spending more time on your work than with your family. And how sad is that?
Most people can't even help it. You know, they sacrifice on the sleep, they sacrifice on so much in life.
I've long since retired, and my son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. I like the tone, the change of voice in this verse. He actually changed his voice. I love the guitaring tune too. Down, 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 I have heard this song before. It's Ugly Kid Joe's
version that I've sung. Yeah,
I've seen the Cradle. I have heard their version a couple of times maybe in the past. I've long since retired and my son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I could find the time. Oh, that is really, really sad. And then he goes on to give his excuses that my daughter has a flu, I think the kids have a flu.
I know.
And I've got things to do, so you know, I just can't make it. I just can't come down to
it's
see you.
It's deja vu.
It's deja vu, yes. It's deja vu. Not deja vu exactly, because
similar.
Deja vu is something that you thought you saw and then it would actually happen.
This is kind of, you know, repetition of what is a history repeats itself.
Yeah, history repeats itself. What goes around comes around. So it's really, really beautiful. The story of mine, Little Rekha, is really, really comes to mind so strongly. I didn't realize what a strong topic, but it does connect. It was based on my own life, and my father was one of those people who really worked long hours. He really worked very far away from home, Monday to Saturday on most days. Even on public holidays, he would end up going to the office, and I never really saw him. I mean, I'll be honest, apart from Sunday afternoons and evenings, I never really spent time with my father.
On the contrary, my dad was almost always around us. You know, he would be 9 to 5. He had a 9 to 5 job, and he would be leaving just 8:45 and coming back by 5:15, and we would be fed up because he was a very strict dad. Oh. So it was the opposite of all the other things.
Yeah.
We would be fed up. When is he gonna be away for a while so that we can have more fun? Because he would be quite strict with us.
The thing is that these lyrics, these things have had an impact on me, my own experience of course, foremost with my father, because when I got married and when we had a kid, it completely changed. For me, this, I learned my lesson. So I realized that, you know, I must spend time with my son.
Yeah,
as
we are
much
on the opposite
possible.
Of this.
So I made it a point to first take half day work, and I mean, it was my own business, so it was a little bit easier. So I decided to cut down on my work hours and then completely work from home as soon as it got comfortable after a few years. So I do realize the importance of spending time with loved ones and things like that, because I never had that good fortune. So I, of course, my mother spent, thanks in heavens for that. And I hope she's watching. She was a great mom, and I mean, she was exactly the opposite of this. She was always there, all important moments of my life. She was always, always there. Right from the time I crawled till I said my first word till the time I got married. Every time she was there. I mean, she was a great mom. You see, my new job's a hassle and the kids have the flu. But it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. Oh, that really hurts you when you get those excuses. But it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me, he grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. Oh, those are sad lines. When you hear that, or if you've gone through that, something similar experience, it is really, really painful. Really, really painful.
It's an overwhelming song. Yeah.
And everything was pieced together so beautifully. The music, the guitar mainly. Great, 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 great tune. So catchy, and the lyrics fitted in so beautifully. The tone of the voice, everything was beautiful. I'm sure this song has got international recognition, not just national recognition if it's from America. I'm sure it has won awards, and I'm sure it was well received by the masses, because this connects with people. This can really change lives. This one song can impact the right person, and if it's heard at the right time, and if that person takes the message strongly, this person can change his life with this one
whoever
listen of this song.
Whoever is going through this, they will definitely, you know, instantly, this song will hit them, because this is what they need. This is a reminder, this is a guidance, this is a knowledge that they need, you know, a reflection of their own.
And then the final verse comes, so I won't get into that, but, you know, just... we can do little things. As a counselor, when I actually formed this story, not just based on my own experience, but also based on my learning experience, attending workshops in psychology in my college days, And I realized that it's actually very simple. You know, everything big, we think it's difficult. But if you take that first step, say you're really busy. Say you're one of those people who works really hard, 14 hours, 16 hours a day. Say you're one of those teenagers who's watching this reaction, who spends most of his time outside the home at college, school, college, or with the peers, with friends, or just alone hanging out here and there. It's really easy to spend some quality time with your loved ones. Just take that first step. Do something little today or tomorrow. Start by spending just 2 minutes. 2 minutes makes a gigantic difference to someone who has not spent 2 hours with you for 2 months of their life. So it can make a gigantic difference. And there are millions in that category. I'm sure there are no stats that can document this or prove it, what I just said. But I'm sure that there are millions or over a billion people who do not even spend 2 hours of quality time with their loved ones. In a week maybe. Let's not call it a month, but a week. So it's really, really important to get started. Just 2 minutes, just 4 minutes, 5 minutes. Get started. You'll realize it's really easy. Just sit. Don't even have to have a conversation. Just sit with that person. Do something. Get involved in a hobby. Talk about common things, things that both of you like or dislike. So talk about things. Just spend time together. Get started. And once you get started, you actually start liking it. And you, in no time, just in a month or so, will actually be spending 2 hours a day maybe with your loved ones. What is your final take, Kirti? Because we don't want to waste too much time. It's a 20-minute reaction, so we should try and stick to it. Because sometimes we go over and it, you know, it lessens the number of views we get. It isn't rotated as much because people do realize. I mean, it's all about time here.
I'll quickly tell you one point that always comes in my mind, and I read a quote about it just a couple of months ago. Those who say they don't have the time, it's just an excuse because everybody knows where to, what to prioritize and where to put that time. It is this way. So at times, most people may not agree with me and may not like what I'm saying, but most people don't have their heart in the right place when it comes to spending that time.
Quality time.
So many parents, fathers or mothers don't spend time, and then they give the pretext or the excuse that I've been very busy working very hard and that is why I'm not spending time. I feel more than half the cases, they are busy enjoying something else. That's why they don't find this more enjoyable to spend the time
addictions
with their
kids. And things like that.
And that's the pity, you know, that's the pity of this entire thing. It's not that you don't have the time, you don't want to remove the time, you don't want to make the time, you don't want, your priorities are not straightened. And that's what I feel. I know most people, you know, those who don't get the time, they really don't get the time, but there are many, and there are many who don't want to put that effort.
I agree. I've seen that in my own cases.
I've seen in many
with
cases.
Clients'
that's
cases,
why I
with students' cases, as well as in real life. I mean, with
friends. I've
family.
Seen it many times.
They have the time.
They
but
have
still
friends
they
and they
to,
have other things and they have other pressing things that, that, you know, pull them towards that. And they don't want to give that time.
Yeah, so let's end on that note. What a great way to end this session. This reaction. Thanks for the Patreon request. You too can request one song, couple of songs, three songs, as you wish. There are various styles to suit everybody, everyone's times, everyone's limit, everyone's budget. So hop on to our Patreon. The link is in the description of this video. And we do hope to see you very, very soon. We are very, very grateful for the time you have spent watching this reaction and watching other reactions on our channel, if you have. We're really grateful. We love that you spend this time with us.
Spend it with your loved ones.
Yeah.
Watching it together.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Dhanyavaad.
Thanks for watching.
And thank you, YouTube, once again, for making all this possible.